the deeper you get into this place, you realize it's horrific, it's brutal.
We're breaking down the stereotype and the mold of what pirates are in the collective consciousness.
Generally in pirate shows or pirate films, it all becomes very much about this little kind of world where it's guys going after treasure, getting the treasure island, the map, and like in X, whereas this is much more about the reality of what it would be.
Call up your men. You can't, can you?
When you hear the word pirate, what you think about is the old kind of stylized, like, yarr, pirates.
Pirates weren't really about a parrot on your shoulder and eyeliner. There's a lot of characters in the show who were real people. There's a grit to them that's very raw and very, very dangerous.
This is definitely different from what we know of the pirate genre, because it's just a lot darker. And that's the reality of that is definitely not shied away from in this.
Civilization is coming, and it means to exterminate us.
These are real guys who just decided they will not abide by these laws that are coming from across the sea, and they're gonna live their lives as they see fit.
So we've made for ourselves a different life, where we don't rely on wages, and where our pleasure isn't a sin, it's a virtue.
There's definitely a certain set of rules and traditions that are existing in the pirate world.
It was a more democratic world where pirate captains are voted on by their crew.
Here, everyone is equal.
Any person at any moment can challenge any of the leadership structure.
When you are strong, you are a necessary evil. When you are not strong, you are likely soon to be dead.
Amongst that, you have all the intrigue and the human interactions based on a piratical charter.
What does the crew think of me? I know they've always found me
too weak.
I was gonna say unlucky.
The whole politics between the pirates, it's just this whole power struggle, really.
It's an entire society that thrives on thievery.
It is survival of the fittest. It's kill or be killed.
You start to understand how subjugated these people were. It starts to make sense that they would decide to go into business for themselves and to kind of reject that system that put them in that position.
Then whoever arrives on our shores first, be it England or Spain, be in for a most unwelcome surprise.
And in some respect, it becomes a very contemporary story at that point. It's a story about people who feel disenfranchised, who feel like the economic system they're living under really is not built for them, and in the worst case is actually built against them. And once you start to sort of see it that way, it's a different world. Now they're not people swinging across ropes and having an adventure. They're people who are struggling against a system that's unjust.
It's never really been seen before how crazy it is to be a pirate and how crazy the people are.